फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। सो इन द टुडेस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वन मोर प्रॉब्लम दैट कम्स व्हेन वी एग्जीक्यूट मल्टीपल ट्रांजैक्शंस इन अ कॉन्करेंट मैनर। ओके, एंड दिस प्रॉब्लम इज कॉल्ड लॉस्ट अपडेट प्रॉब्लम। इन द लास्ट वीडियो we studied about the dirty read problem. Okay, so in this video we are going to discuss the lost update problem. Okay, so firstly try to understand the condition. We have three accounts present in the database table. Okay, Aarti and Neha both are purchasing some item of rupees 5000 from the Flipkart online shopping site. Okay, so they both, Aarti and Neha, want to transfer rupees 5000 from their accounts to the Flipkart's account. Okay, and we have two transactions. One transaction is Aarti is transferring rupees 5000 from her account to the Flipkart account, and the second transaction is Neha is transferring rupees 5000 from her account to the Flipkart account. So I have made these two transactions like this. Okay, and I already told you what is the meaning of concurrency. Concurrency means when we are executing multiple transactions in parallel so that we can reduce the first time response of the transaction so that user has to wait for a less amount of time. That is the reason that we are doing parallel processing of multiple transactions. If you are executing multiple transactions serially, then there is no any problem like dirty read and lost update. This problem arises when we have to execute multiple transactions in a concurrent or parallel mode. So if we want to get the some advantage, then we want to speed up the execution of multiple transactions, then also we have to face some problems. Okay, so now what we are trying to do, in the later videos we will discuss that how we can avoid such kind of problems in the concurrency. Okay, but in this video I am telling you what is the meaning of the lost update problem. Okay, and I am doing scheduling of both of these transactions in this manner. Okay, and there is no fixed rule that after these many instructions you are going to switch to another transaction. At any particular point of time, at any instruction, you can switch from one transaction to the another transaction. Okay, so we have to take care of each and every step. Okay, so I am executing both these transactions in a parallel mode. So what I am doing initially, firstly CPU is running this transaction T1. Okay, as this transaction is transferring 5000 rupees from Aarti's incrementing 5000 rupees from this balance. Okay, so I decremented it and all this operation is happening in the main memory. Okay, now what I want to do, I want to reflect this change in money into the database. I want to now update the database value. So for that I am using the write operation. Write operation, you know, you can use update query of SQL for performing the write operation. So I am updating 15,000 here. Okay, so now after performing this update operation, our timer is out. So we have to switch from this transaction to this transaction T2. We have executed some of the instructions of transaction T1. Now we are moving to the transaction T2. Okay, so if you look at in this concurrent, in this parallel mode of execution, your transaction T2 is getting response, the first time response, very faster. Okay, if you have to execute both these transactions in a serial mode, then what would happen? Firstly, you are going to run all of the instructions of this transaction, then you will be moving to transaction T2. But in the parallel mode of execution, just after executing the three instructions of transaction T1, we are moving to the transaction T2. So the response time, the first time response, is very fast. Okay, so now what we are doing in this transaction? In this transaction, I want to transfer 5000 rupees from Neha's account to the Flipkart's account. Okay, and let me tell you one thing, both these transactions are happening simultaneously at the same point of time. Both Harti and Neha are doing online payment at the same time. Okay, so now what I want to do, I want to deduct rupees 5000 from the Neha's account. So what I want to do, I am fetching the Neha's balance value. So I fetch here 30,000. Okay, now I deducted 5000 rupees from 30,000 and this operation is done in the main memory. So now you have value 25,000 in the main memory. Okay, but I want to update this change in the database. So I will be updating this value 25,000 in the database with the help of this write operation. So I am making here 25,000. Okay, so next our time is out. We have to print. We have to switch from transaction T2 to transaction T1. Okay, so in this transaction, Aarti is transferring 5000 rupees in the Flipkart's balance. So we have to add 5000 rupees in the Flipkart's balance. So firstly, I am reading the Flipkart's balance value. It is actually 50,000. Okay, and I added 5000 rupees to the 50,000. Now I am having 55,000. Okay, and this change we are doing in the main memory. Till now we have not done any write operation or any write operation or any. So till now we have not done any update or write operation in the database. Okay, so still in the database we are having 50,000, but in the main memory our value is 55,000. Okay, so before I could done the update operation in the database, the another transaction. They both are running independently in an isolation mode. Okay? So, we are transferring 5000 from Neha to Flipkart's account. So, firstly, I am going to read the Flipkart's balance value from the database. What is the database value? 50,000. Okay? We added in this transaction 5000 rupees. But as we didn't done the right operation, still we have 50,000 value present in the database. So, I am going to fetch the 50,000 value. Okay? And I am adding 5000 rupees in the 50,000. Okay? So, after performing this operation in the main memory, I got printed. Time is out, so I am switching from this transaction to this transaction. Now, this transaction T1 is doing the update operation or the write operation. Whatever changes it has made, whatever changes this transaction T1 has made, now it is going to update that change in the database. So, it is going to perform the write operation. Whatever value we have here, 55,000. Okay, we are performing the write operation in the database. So, this value we are going to update in the database. So, I am making here 55,000. Okay, now I got printed to this transaction T2. This transaction T2 also wants to perform the update operation in the database. Okay, whatever changes this transaction has made, it is now want to update that operation. So, we have a value of 55,000. Okay, it is going to write that value in the database. So, whatever is the value present in the database, you are going to update that value with 55,000. Okay, next you are switching to transaction T1. We are committing all these operations. Okay, we are committing all these operations. Whatever changes it has done, we are now going to make it permanent. Okay, then we are switching to this transaction. Whatever changes this transaction has made, we are going to make all the changes permanent in the database. So, if you look at after performing the execution of both these transactions, this is the final state of your database. These are the final values you are getting in your database. But is this state right? Is this state consistent? We transfer rupees 5000 from Aadi's account to Flipkart's account. Okay, we transferred 5000 rupees from Neha's account to Flipkart's account. So, what should be my amount in the Flipkart? My amount should be 60,000. Initially, we had value 50,000, but now we have transferred 10,000 more in the Flipkart's account balance. So, it should be now 60,000. But what is the value I am having? 55,000. So, where is my 5,000 rupees? We are getting loss of rupees 5,000. Why it is happening so? What is the reason that we are getting loss? So, in this case, if you look at both these transactions are running in isolation. Okay, this transaction is reading some value. Okay, this transaction is also reading some value. But both are reading the same values from the database. lost. Whatever transaction is getting executed at the last, that change you will be seeing in the database value. Okay, so whatever changes this transaction has made, this change is not reflected in the database. So this transaction updation is actually lost. Okay, because both these transactions are reading the same database value and they both want to modify it. Okay, whatever modification this transaction D1 is doing, it has been lost. So what could be the right way if we have to execute these two transactions? Firstly, this transaction T1 modified the Flipkart balance value, and then transaction T2 read the modified value of transaction T1. Then we could avoid this kind of problem. Okay, but it is important that firstly we commit this transaction and then we read the value in another transaction. Okay, so it is very important, firstly you commit your one transaction and then you read the value from the committed transaction, so that we can avoid such kind of problem. This is called the lost update problem, because whatever changes your first transaction is doing in the Flipkart balance, that change is completely lost. Okay, so this is basically the lost update problem. We will find some solutions that how we can manage this kind of problems. Okay, we definitely have to execute multiple transactions in parallel mode, because speed is the necessity of today's time. So we have to handle this kind of problems so that we can get the right output. So I hope that you are clear with lost update problem. If you have any query, I have mentioned my email ID in the description box. You can contact me on that email ID. So thank you so much for watching my video. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe my channel.